Kajingalang jong ka kenhun menteri Hinden khatsaw terik unai lar kala menjur ya kerai bansya ya ka Meghalaya Power Distribution Corporation Limited ni MEPDCL banwat pisa si hajar lais pa sapsan penyopu artlur tingka ban penkhut ya karam halor ki kendon wanra kajing hiar ha kajing duok long ha ka aggregate technical and commercial ban penjan ya ka average cost of supply but ka average revenue realized. Habaklan bagi lap saya kubur hadirin kencing lang umentri ketenat kambording ke sorkar jela u James K sangma ulang baka MEPDCL jongka corporation kadon karam bansiu ya kabai boarding syaka central power generating stations but syaka power grid corporation of India limited.
The MEPDCL has a very huge outstanding against power purchase dues payable to the central power generating stations and also to PGCIL, that's a transmission company. The revenue collection, as we all know, has been adversely affected due to COVID-19. And with all these things taken into consideration, there has been a notification by the Government of India wherein it has announced that the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme to infuse liquidity to distressed DISCOMs in the form of loans backed by a state government guarantee would be, this opportunity would be given to clear the liabilities of the GenCos and the TransCos by the state DISCOMs. So, under the scheme, the Rural Electrification Corporation and the Power Finance Corporation would extend special long-term transition loans up to 10 years to DISCOMs on certain conditions. And these conditions would be for which, under which Meghalaya would qualify was namely for DISCOMs that do not have receivables from the state government or headroom available under the working capital limits imposed under ODER, the states may request the Government of India for relaxation of the borrowing limit. So, therefore, this matter was placed before the cabinet that to clear off these outstanding liabilities to the public sector undertakings, namely the generation companies like NEEPCO, NTPC, OTPC, and transmission companies like PGCIL. The proposal was placed before the cabinet for Meghalaya Power Development Corporation Limited, the MEPDCL, to avail the assistance restricted to 1345, that is rupees 1345 crores, 0.72 under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan scheme. This was one. Number two, to enhance the borrowing limit of the MECL by rupees 1345.72 crores for the purpose on and above its existing borrowing limit of rupees 2500 crores. And number three, for the state government to give a guarantee for the proposed loan of 1345 crores. And number four, to obtain approval from the Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Power, Government of India, for the relaxation of the borrowing limit of the MEPDCL as restricted under ODER to avail the proposed loan. So with this loan amount, MEPDCL would be able to clear all outstanding dues. At the same time, the MEPDCL would also be writing to Ministry of Power and to all these generating companies for waiver of delayed payment surcharges. So we are asking them if they can give us more than 60% of waiver of the delayed payment surcharges.